Otherwise, I mean, you're looking at longer term sort of stories play out, but you have to be clear about that as well. Then these kind of moves should not bother you, Sonia.
There's a saying, right, that we've heard so many times in the market that markets take the stairs up and the elevator down. So it looks like that's happening, at least in some stocks. The mid-cap index, by the way, it's a real shakeout. 400 points lower as we speak, 1.5% already gone on the mid-cap index. In fact, that's a good time to invite our market master, Aditya Narayan, the head of research institutional equities at Edelweiss Securities, joins us now to give us a sense of what to do here on. Aditya, that's the big question, right? What do you do with the momentum boys if you've made money in them? So IRCTC, Tata Power, IEX, created great wealth for investors, but is this the time to book out? Your views?
You know, I think in a lot of these individual stocks that you named and a couple of others, I think the kind of returns you've made have been, you know, over the top, let me just put it that way. So I think it's only fair to take some money off the table on some of these. You know, I think when you reach a market which starts seeing what you could call irrational responses from stocks on the upside, you know, it's time to be a little careful. And it is a little reflective of the entire market too. You know, I was on the air when the market crossed 60,000, and you know, that was a big benchmark to beat. And here, a couple of weeks later, we are at 62,000. So I think when you've got so much momentum, which is out of the ordinary, as in it is not aligned with a lot of global markets, plus you have individual stocks just going through the roof, you know, it does make sense to take some money off the table.
Okay, this is an utter mid-cap collapse. Just look at what's going on. The index is suddenly down 2%. I mean, to quote Sonia, this is the elevator coming down very, very swiftly in the mid-cap side of the market. And this is something you really cannot ignore. After what happened yesterday, something has spooked the broader market investors out there. And things are really coming off very quickly. I want to pull up some more stocks before we take our next question with Aditya. Adani Power, JK Tyre, you know, NALCO is down 4.5%, ICICI Prudential, Prestige, Firstsource. Of course, you'll argue that a lot of these stocks went up. So this wouldn't be a surprise. But the ferocity with which the sell down has happened, minus any visible trigger. And Aditya, that's my question to you. You know, in a bull market, I think shakeouts just happen. But this time around, over the last 24 hours, I don't know what exactly is it that has suddenly sort of unnerved people out there. Can you put your mind to anything? Overall, markets have been holding up. Global cues are all right. There's still risk on. People are still buying the Bitcoin. So what's happened here?
No, you know, typically what happens is when markets move up so much, they also tend to get a little bit more edgy. And what you've seen is there are a couple of numbers which have come.
It's okay. We'll just come back to you in a bit, Aditya. Looks like we're having some issue with that video. But yes, it's not just the mid-caps now. Even the frontliners have started to fall quite a bit. 80 points gone on the Nifty. I mean, of course, this fall pales in comparison to the rise we've seen in the last 1 year. But it's still nevertheless looking like a bit of a sticky day. Aditya, sorry, we had an issue. You were saying something about the sell-off?
So what I was saying was that I think a little bit of it has been triggered in the backdrop of very strong markets by the fact that a couple of large companies have kind of disappointed vis-à-vis expectations. Now, those disappointments haven't been large. They aren't against the run of play, which is businesses generally looking better. But the fact that you've had markets which have moved so much, stocks which have moved so much, there is a little bit of skittishness, I would say, in the market. And that starts playing through into stock prices when you do see some of these disappointments. So I would tend to believe if there is a trigger, it's the fact that large stocks have lost large value on the back of small misses. And that, you know, nervousness tends to extend to some of the smaller ones or the ones that have moved up more sharply. So I think it's really a combination of that rather than anything specific beyond that. You know, you have to remember, as I said, I think these markets are elevated. They are elevated relative to the rest of the world. And, you know, to some extent, this is just natural that it'll happen. Mind you, I think we have for some time been saying that you just need to be a little bit more cautious at this point in time. And the larger caps is where it's a little safer to be.
Absolutely. I mean, I completely agree with Aditya. Just take a look at some of these stocks. This is all from the F&O side. Actually, look at IEX. It's down 10%. The rate will come up on your screen. Look at Deepak Nitrite. That is down 10%, 2633. There is IRCTC, of course, which is down about 10%. Dixon is down 9%. Dixon at about 52.25 or so, 52.40. There is Navin Fluorine, which is down 9%. There is what else? Mastec, which is down 12.5%. That is, of course, responding to growth momentum slowing down. Vedanta is down 4%. L&T Technology Services, which reported fairly decent numbers, is down about 5%. So this is, you know, meaningful cuts for a day. But, you know, keep in mind the run-ups that many of these have seen. ICICI Pru, which reported numbers, is down 5.5%. Tata Chemicals, which got re-rated basically on the day that TPG Tata Motors deal came through, 4% lower on Tata Chemicals. It's at about 1,036. And I can go on with more names, but this is the large volume, heavy volume part of the market, which is selling off. Aditya, so I think you left off, you finished that last answer by saying that look for areas with valuation comfort at these very elevated levels. Is banking one such space?
Typically, yes. If you look at the market, I think the two areas where we would have comfort, one would be in banking, where from a valuation perspective, they remain relatively modest. They haven't moved the way a lot of the other sectors have. Plus, I think the fact that the economic cycle is looking better, I think the possibilities and the probabilities of loan growth beginning to come through are much higher there than there are than would be the case in the broader market. So I think there is an underlying argument for them, plus from a valuation and a stock performance perspective, you have relative comfort there compared with the rest of the market. The other one that, you know, we have harped about a little bit in the past is really on the IT space, where we just believe the demand cycle is so assured over the next couple of years that there is a fair amount of cushion that you have in taking stock calls when the demand outlook is as good as it is. I think everything in between in the market, or almost everything in between, is a little bit more suspect to what the demand outlook will be beyond the immediate, or will the pace be as significant as what the market is extrapolating. So I think these other spaces is where you need to be a little bit more cautious than necessarily as far as the banking space is concerned, or as I said, at the other extreme, at the other end of the spectrum, which is the IT space.
Okay, well, it's not all down and out. Yes, there is a shakeout in the mid-cap space, but there are stocks and sectors that are bucking the trend as well. FMCG is enjoying its day out in the sun. So you have all these stocks, you know, whether it's Nestle, which is up 3.5% right now, big buying there. HUL is in the green. Britannia is in the green. Aditya, the commentary from the FMCG players has been quite commendable and encouraging. And these stocks are also reacting. Is this a time to be adding on some more, considering that, you know, there's a big recovery in the economy, people are spending more? How do you approach this space?
See, I think from a portfolio perspective, they make a little bit more sense because they are much more defensive. The numbers, as I said, they've missed a little bit, but the underlying trends are decent. And at some level, they've been able to manage this whole inflation paradox much better than you would have argued, given how rapid the pickup in inflation has been, right? That said, as an individual stock level, I would tend to be a little bit more measured because, you know, they are richly valued. Growth is not looking beyond what it used to be. It's really getting back to where it used to be. So I would say it would be a more neutral space rather than one where you will necessarily make meaningful money. But yes, given that you are seeing a little bit of a pullback, that the market is reacting to, you know, slightly inflated stock runs, and sectoral expectations, it is a little safer to be in this space than some of the other more discretionary driven businesses and stocks.
Okay. Just trying to figure it out. I mean, what could be possible triggers? One reason it might not be true, Aditya, let me ask you this. You know, we all know that the market cap categorization, the semi-annual changes that are announced by AMFI, the next change kicks in only in January. It's a, you know, once in 6 months kind of a review. But could it be that some sort of portfolio churn has already begun in anticipation because we're now winding down October? I'm just sort of flying kites here, trying to figure out what has suddenly spooked the broader market.
I would suspect that's far too early. You know, not that I've seen too many expectations being put out in hard form. I think it's a couple of weeks before these events happen that you see a certain amount of churning or rebalancing or positioning for what might happen. But I think we are still in October. Let's not get It's like the multiples that are being ascribed to a lot of businesses way out there. Let's not get so carried away.
2050, 2051 multiples, right? I take your point, Aditya. Prashant, your question.
No, I mean, Surabhi, on the point of reasons, right? Mm-hmm. I think, I mean, you don't have to have any reason, yeah. right? I mean, essentially, these are huge. This is, as I think Aditya himself put it, mm-hmm. to put it mildly, absolutely unnatural kind of moves. And names like IRCTC, mm-hmm. etc., right?
And quite honestly, you know, there's a lot of debate on them when they're on their way down. There isn't as much conversation.
Exactly.
And that elevator stairs thing, I think, you know, we talk about the elevator down. We don't talk about the elevator that we take up.
Exactly. The point is, when it is going up, I mean, you know, unless you question when it is going up, I mean, unless you have a real sense of why it is going up and, you know, you can feel happy if it is going up and you own it, but the point is you have to have some fundamental basis for it to go up, because when it starts to turn, then you won't know what's happening on the way down.
We're told not to question momentum, right?
Momentum works both ways, right?
Absolutely. No, it is absolutely fine if you're doing momentum, Surabhi, but the point is then you have to know it is momentum, nothing else, and then you kind of trade accordingly.
Absolutely.
I think that's the point that Aditya was also making. Great to have you with us here, Aditya. Always great speaking with you. Thanks very much. The market, by the way, I think it's recovered. We are down about 45 points. 18,373 is where we are at. So off the lows by a little bit. The mid-cap index should also come up. I think there is also, is there a little bit of recovery? The Nifty mid-cap index, we'll have that up on your screens. Yes, there is a little bit. I think we're about 0.5% off from the lows on the mid-cap index as well. Sonia.
Yeah, and we shouldn't get carried away with the drastic pace at which it fell in the morning, because there's a lot of buying. I mean, look at FMCG, look at technology stocks, look at something like an Asian Paints, Divi's Labs. There's a lot of buying in the market. So for now, we've stabilized. Gives us some good time to ponder on the good set of earnings that came through. The standout for us definitely was L&T Technologies. Strong set of Q2 earnings, well above estimates. The company also raised its FY20.